Hey there, guys and gals and YouTubers. Welcome back. Welcome back to Space Engineers. So I am kind of out and about capturing ships. Kind of started a chain reaction. I initially was going to out capturing a private sail. Got that guy. Started capturing some of the assailants that came with it. Then I saw this mine carriage. And I captured that, and then I just got this other assailant that was going to the aid of this mine carriage. So I'm kind of, there's actually some weird ship down here. I don't know what this is, the Argentavis. It's kind of scary. I bet it's some sort of AI pirate giant ship that's kind of like scouting around. But he seems pretty far away. So anyways, let's actually, I'm trying to disable these assailants. Let's see here, can I bring that over? No, I can't. Actually take this ammo out here. Because they're kind of despawning, and I don't know why they are. I kind of was thinking it was these programmable blocks. But I might have to, once I get control over them, clear out the program in there, because what I initially did on a couple of them was just grind out these blocks here, the programmable blocks, these timer blocks, and this other programmable block, and this remote control. And then basically got the beacon, and basically all the other stuff, the gyroscope and the reactor. Over to me, and I went off to go to this mining carriage, and I think they both despawn, so I don't know what's going on. So I'm thinking I might have to clear this programmable block out here. I think it's got a program in there. If you're kind of away too far, it kind of it might despawn it, or maybe there's a setting in this scenario where there's a trash removal and this is not really considered a craft, because it really doesn't really have a cockpit. It's just kind of some weird random thing floating out there. So I'm thinking it may be one of the two, so I'm gonna actually try to clear out this. That actually looks like it's getting closer. I don't remember the initial distance. We're actually kind of far out from our base. Let's see if he's heading over towards our base. Where is our base? There's a lot of clutter. I think, okay, main base is over here. I don't think he's heading that way. So let's get this job done and get out of here as soon as possible. Let's check out this programmable block. That I'm thinking that's a pretty good sized ship. Remote control, I don't have that. I thought I had that. Oh, I didn't get that block yet. I'm just kind of messing around, grinding this stuff down. And we'll probably need to head back to base anyways. We're going to go swing over to the private sail and see if those assailants are still over there. I don't know if they are. These signals are, you can't really see them because they're cluttered up a little bit. So yeah, like I said, I'm just messing about here. So he's actually, yeah, he's going further away. Oh, that shows your, is that the direction or is that just, okay, no, that's just where he's showing up on the HUD. So let's check out programmable block, edit. Yeah, we can probably. Can't we delete this? Because I think even though I grind it out, that code's still in here. Wish there was a clear button. Control A? Yes. That works. Remember an exit? Or just do a close out. Do you want to remember changes? Yes. Control A selects all and I'm just deleting them. So yeah, I'm just checking these out here, like I said. Maybe I should have actually just turn them off. It'll probably work better that way. I really don't know. I'm gonna actually turn the power off anyways, so I just wanted to make sure. Reactor off. Alright. So let's hook this guy up and we'll head over to the private sale. So yeah, there's a lot of new stuff in here that I'm not familiar with, but I kinda like it. It's makes the game really fresh and new for me. And this is why I love these mining carriages. See if I can get them all hooked up. Alrighty, let's where is that private sale down that way? So I'm assuming not. There was another assailant that came after this. I keep looking at that pirate thing. It looked like it was closer with that triangle. It's not, it's just heading out. I think the AI probably kind of patrolled the system. That's what I'm assuming. And there's probably big frigate type ships that are around doing that. So that's kind of cool. We're gonna have to be careful of that. I ended up taking cyber hounds off, disabling that. Because I haven't been down to the planet Earth yet, but I've been watching videos on it, other YouTubers. Starting survival mode down in the planet, and I just don't like the way the cyber hounds are. I left the spiders on. I think that's a pretty cool idea, but the cyber hounds, it just seems like as soon as you hit the surface and land there, you start getting attacked by the hounds right away. So I was really turned off by that. Oh, the assailant is there. Nice. I see it. It was just clustered in there. There should be two over there. Awesome. Maybe. I don't remember how many I got from that. I felt like I captured two. There's the other one. Awesome. So they did stay in. So all I had to do was just grind those blocks out. So I didn't have to take the code out. So that's cool. So we gotta come back for these guys here. So yeah, the idea of the cyber hounds is just kind of. I mean. It's kind of weird just coming on the planet anyways. Hopefully I don't ram this guy. I think I'm kind of far out. His brakes are pretty good. It's just kind of weird having these weird cyber hounds on the planet. And it's like I said, as soon as you hit the surface, they start attacking you, and then you gotta worry about making turrets and stuff. I mean, that's kind of a cool option. Maybe it's some people's idea of a game, but it's not mine really. Maybe if they made like kind of like bears and then made those cyberhounds actually wolves or something. That would kind of make more sense. So the salience I'm gonna leave here. I'm gonna come back for the private cell myself, and then come back with the other, or just bring back this carriage and grab these two other assailants. So I gotta figure out main bases this way, I think. It's so hard to tell. We'll just go in between those guys. So we should be there pretty fast with this carriage. So that's cool. I really, really glad that the assailants weren't despawned. So yeah, the cyberhounds, when you kill them, they give you like motors, or they give you components and stuff like that, but they attack so often. I think they attack a lot at night, so it's kind of like almost playing a one of those weird survival games, like a zombie apocalypse game where you constantly get attacked. Which it's kind of weird in this kind of game, because this is more of like a builder type game, and there's survival elements in it, but it never really started out that way, this kind of game. I feel like they just kind of threw those in there and just said, you know what, let's see if how people react with it. But if they kind of fixed maybe the AI on them, where they don't attack so often every once in a while, or they hang out in a certain area on the planet, that would be kind of cool. But no, I don't like those waves. Where it's like you turn this kind of space exploration game into like a tower defense game. But it makes the turrets and the missile turrets useful. You actually can use them for something, but we got AI pirates in here, so I don't know. It's just not my thing right now. The spires I'm kind of interested in, because the spires, I think they spawn in on the planets, or the alien planet. So let's head on. We should be almost there. Let's start to throttle down. These things nowadays take a little bit to slow down. And I'll show you how the how I got the private cell. It's actually quite different than I remembered it. I had to do it a few times. Oh, we better be careful of our platform. I didn't see it rendering just till now. And what we'll do, I think we're on the bottom here. I'm kind of working on the platform a little bit. You kind of see there's a little bit something on the bottom there. And I'll just leave. I need to attach the assailant. Should be okay. Let's jump out. I'm gonna. Oh, let's actually take the landing gear off. I'm gonna probably turn the engines back on that. Just in case if I bump it, it won't fly out anywhere. So we'll turn her on. And turn you on. So, yeah, I'm kind of working on this weird design. I kind of want to put like a beacon coming off of here. And then, since the sun, I notice the sun comes in this arc here. I kind of want to put the panels here, and then I want to put them on a motor. And I think I'm gonna mess around with the timing block and maybe have it rotate so often, so it kind of follows the sun. I don't know. Maybe. Or at least have the rotator or a rotate block, and I can actually control it myself and then just rotate it, tilt it where the sun's at. But yeah, I'm gonna put another set over here. And I don't know, I may stretch this out. I don't know. I'm kind of messing around with the design on this. We'll see how it goes. So since we're here, we actually need to get some fill up on the oxygen and my health. I took some damage out there. It's a rough world. Let's go in here first. Yeah, oxygen's pretty low. So we're good to go. I've been out there for a while out there, guys. A long time. And we're good to go. We're ready to go back out there. Oh, I don't have my pirate. Oh, actually, I do. Save. All right, we need to head on over. There's ice up there. I didn't see that before. So hard with all these different. So I ended up. Remember, I died and I lost the location of my body. Ended up going to another save and found the GPS coordinates. And I just basically came back into this save and plugged it in, so I don't have to load up another save and save off of that. I just came in and got the coordinates and loaded up in there. So now it's kind of a lander question mark, because I don't know if the lander is actually there. So wow, there is so many signals. I really, hopefully, magnesium. Okay, I see assailants this way, so let's. I think these lines up here on top mean there's like four different signals. And if you hit the left alt button, kind of you can read stuff. But it really doesn't give you much detail till you get closer. So I think the two assailants are there. Maybe the private sail. No, there's the other assailant. I think that's what that means. There's two signals there, I think, or is just. I don't see the private cell yet. I don't know if that would despawn. I thought I. There it is. It just didn't render in. Oh yeah, that's right. These are set up for 10 kilometers. Huh. Forgot about that. So they will go out of range. I did not know. I gotta remember that because I probably lost some other assailants out there. I just kind of flew too far away from them. I don't know. All right, let's grab this private sail, and I gotta come back and get these two assailants. And I'll show you how to I grab this pirate private sail. Back in the day, they used to be pretty easy to get because they didn't have. I don't think they had a turret on it back then. Because I remember when cargo ships first came out, I think they went through a stage where they didn't have turrets, and then they put turrets on them and they didn't work for a long time. The only things you had to worry about with some of them were booby traps. That was always a thing. And then I think once they got the turrets working, I think they added one of the private sail. I don't remember, because I don't remember these guys having two guns on them. So basically, what you gotta do is you have to approach them from the front, because the two guns are back here, and you have to approach them almost at an angle here. That's the bottom of the craft, and the guns are right there, and they're kind of blocked by the solar panel and the engines there. So once you approach, you come down in here. Just kind of ease on in here, and then once you get in here, get low, sneak up here, grind out this triangular block. Move in here really quick, you might take a little bit of damage. Grind out this triangular block, grind out this triangular block, and then there's a square block in here, and then you basically come in here and grind this out, and then weld it back up to get control. Turn the dampeners on to stop it, and then you can hit Y to kill the power, and actually kill the power on these guns, and then you can come out and basically disable them, and then you can take control. I think I got the beacon, didn't I? I think I got most blocks except the cargo hold and the batteries. I did get control of the important things, the gyroscope, and I believe, oh, we need to turn that off. I don't know if that's a thing, but we don't want that. And the reactor, there's a reactor on here also, as well as the solar panels, which, am I missing the reactor? Oh, I don't have access to it. Oh, I thought I did. Let's grind that out. Oh, yep, I don't. This is battery, that's battery, and this is the reactor. And we kind of need a reactor at least. And it's actually easier to get the reactor, so we have power over the ship, and instead of trying to grind out those solar panels and make a Mars and the batteries, because I think now if you grind out batteries, you'll lose the power cell components in there. So you basically have to go to assembler and reassemble them. So that's kind of cool that when you grind out batteries, you lose some of the cells. Alrighty, let's find our base. There's main base. Should see it. It's a big asteroid, I think. Pretty far out. Are we actually throttling up or not? Do I have gyroscope? Yes. Turrets, solar panels. That should not matter, really, I don't think. Dampeners off. Oh. Okay, I guess there should be enough. I thought. Yeah, there's plenty of small reactor. It might. That might not be enough to power this, I guess. Let's actually get control of this cargo container and maybe one of these panels. Let's see what's in here actually. Oh, there's some solar cells. The thing about grinding these out, they're pretty heavy. Let's try it again. Take this beast home.
No fuel.
Okay, there we go. I guess the power wasn't on, really.
No fuel.
Okay, I guess we're okay. These private cells are really cool because they give you solar panels and stuff, so you can get started on solar panel right away. And the cool thing is with these, you can just basically almost hook them up to your base right away. If you put a say you take the beacon off here in the front, put a merge block on that, and then put a merge block on your base, you can just hook it right up without even having to grind this guy out, and you'll basically have power right away. So you don't have to sit there and grind all this stuff out, just attach it. Oh, there's another private cell.
No fuel.
So like right now, the mining carriage and the private cell are probably the two crafts that I can actually get. That's the radiant outpost. I thought that was that ship. I was like, he's actually gaining speed on me. There's actually something going on with that outpost. I was looking into the SE toolbox, as it's like a third-party application that you can load up your save, and you can go in there and kind of clean out floating asteroids or floating debris and stuff like that, or spawning things. And it was kind of some of the early toolbox we used a long time ago when Space Engineers came out to edit some stuff in the save game file. But I was actually checking it out to actually convert that platform over from craft to actual platform before I found out that merge block did it. So I was in there and I saw all kinds of scrap metal floating around and some debris. And then I looked from the distance from where I was, and I was actually standing at the base. It was the distance to that outpost. So I'm wondering if somebody was attacking the outpost. Maybe one of these cargo ships flying by. Maybe it was considered a different faction or something and fired upon it. I'm going to have to investigate it one of these days. I might fly over there. Maybe I'll take this sail over. I'll fix it up a little bit and take this over, since it's kind of just a scrappy little craft that I have. And maybe try to get close and see. Do a little recon over there and see what's really going on. Maybe the base is actually disabled by some circumstances. So, because there shouldn't be a bunch of scrap metal unless somebody was shooting at somebody and doing some damage to either a platform or a spacecraft. So I'm about to go over there and check what's going on, because if so, man, if there's disabled somehow, I'm going over and take advantage of that. So yeah, Raven's Junkyard is starting to come alive over here. I don't even have my platform all set up in my base.
No fuel.
The old chop shop. So how are we doing with O2 and everything? We're pretty good. Let's go grab those assailants. I'll probably make this episode a little bit longer. See what time we got in the real world. Guess I got time. All right. Now they were down here, if I remember, towards that silicone. Yes, assailant 2 is right there. And let me see what blocks I have on this guy. I should have all the important ones. Except the cart containers, that's fine. I kind of almost want to empty this because I don't want to lose all this material if something happens. I think I should be okay. Do a quick save. Should be okay. There shouldn't be any dangers out there. Knock on wood. If I lose it, oh well, there's going to be other ones coming around eventually. So I'm going to bring back both of these. I'm going to hook up both of them. Yeah, I forgot things. Beacons have a range. GPS doesn't. It can go on forever. Gotta remember that. I think you can crank these up more. I think, let's see how far. Yeah, that's pretty far. But still, in this infinity kind of universe, it'll eventually disappear. That's why it's best to use GPS for very important things like your base, definitely. But yeah, ships can get lost out here. I miss the old days when these craft used to just break almost instantaneously. Now it just takes forever to slow down, but I kind of understand. It's a little bit more realistic physics. Now we gotta see where, I think we're on the right side here. And I'm going to need to disable the engines on that anyway, so let's go ahead and halt it. Actually, I think we're... let's get closer. These things are... got a low profile on them. Oh, he's actually floating. He's... is he? No, he's not. Looked like he was. I know I took one of the engines off one of these, so if something bumps him, he's going to be rotating pretty good. Let's get on in there. Oh, I'm way off. I'm going the wrong way. And I probably need to tilt her a little bit. So the reason why I disable the engines on these guys is If you hook it up with the lander legs, it kind of acts like part of the ship, so it'll counteract the ship a little bit. So it's easier to tow these guys when you disable the engine. Off. So kind of like towing a car, you have to put it in neutral and get all ready. You're not gonna have the engine on. So I kind of just want the tip of, you know what, I'll grab it from the bottom tip here. Hopefully I can tow both of these back. We'll find out. I mean, we should be okay. We're in zero gravity. I think I can go a little bit higher. Oops. Just get most of the 1 foot on it. Alrighty. I think we can set that to auto lock too. Alrighty, let's see where the other one is. There she is, and she's not too far. And we kind of just don't want to swing it when we turn. Go too fast anyways, because we just don't want it to swing off, so go a little bit slow. So I kind of like the assailants. I mean, I think there's a bug with them right now with the AI stuff, where they don't really chase you, because when they spawn in, I notice they just kind of just sit there and stay where they're at. I was reading in the forums that people were complaining about the AI not chasing the players, and I think it's a bug being the developers are going to have to work on the fix, which makes sense, because these assailants should be chasing after me and coming after me until I disable the ship. But I was paying attention, and it's kind of spawn in and just sit there. They should be at least coming for the cargo ship in distress. There's the, oh, she's still out there. She's on that sector. Yeah, I feel safer once we get most of the... Let's get this assailant, get out of here. I need to work... I really need to get that base up. I need to at least get some sort of defense, some sort of turret going. Even though I don't have conveyors on the platform, I at least want to get some turrets, and I can use these from these mining carriages. Just turn them on when I need them. So let's get out of here as soon as possible. Stop that one. Hopefully it's not spinning, because I think that's the one I disabled the one of the engines, because I needed it for the private sale. I think it's okay. Just these guys, like I said, have a low profile. Looks like they're drifting. So I'm gonna keep this episode going until I get these guys back. Let's see how that He's actually getting closer. Wow. He's not super fast. Well, he actually. Well, he's going at a decent speed. He must see something. And I don't see him moving in any direction on the space, so he may be coming straight at me. Oh boy, this is gonna be fun. Insert sarcasm, please. Get out of here as soon as possible, man. It's scary out here now. Got to defend my junkyard now. All right, we need to take these engines off. Hit tab. Oh yeah, she's gonna be about 9. Oh my goodness, that's scary. Might be able to start to see her pretty soon here. Where is the engine? Over here. Oh my goodness, I'm stressing out. She may see me. I want to get out of the area where she can't, where her signal will actually disappear. So let's head straight to base if we can find it. There it is. Oh, main base is there. Well, I have a feeling probably one of these episodes pretty soon we're gonna get in contact with this AI ship here. Looks like she's doing a sweeping pattern. Raid in progress. That's not good. That is not good. They must have spotted my base. Well, you know what? I got two turrets on these guys. I can enable these guys. So I might use these guys. I might not tear them down. I'll probably, set a perimeter with these little turrets. They're just disabled. The private cell, I have to rebuild those guys. I have a feeling they're going to be coming for me, looking for me. So, yep. Plan on some engagements here. So, yeah, that's the way we end this episode here. Running with our tail between our legs. We have plenty of time to set this up, though. Bring it, guys. Come on, bring it. My base is not built up. I can just take out your ship and then, oh man, I'll be scavenging your ship. I live by the pirate life too. Bring it. You know what? I'll leave these hooked up. Turn those guns on. I'll have a platform here, a shooting platform. I hit the brakes. Going too fast. Coming too fast, we're fine. Think we're up top, aren't we? Okay, the signal is kind of. Well, we're actually kind of still in acceleration here. I'll see here once we're stopped. No, they're coming. So I would expect them to be here in probably at that speed, possibly 10 to 15 minutes, real time. So they probably got word I was capturing ships out here, so they're like, they're gonna want some sort of cut from my pirate base here, and that's not gonna happen. I work alone. This is gonna be interesting. Yeah, they're gonna come. They're. Yep, we're gonna have to take them out. This is gonna be fun. Hopefully, that's not a big ship. But I have a feeling it's pretty good size. I don't know. We'll find out. So, alrighty, guys. I guess that is it for this episode. So, we'll definitely see you next time, guys. Bye bye. Take care out there.